When you take a look at Twist versus Slack, the interesting thing is that it actually matters on what type of plan you get, what makes more sense for you to get what type of plan. So when we look at free, you actually have a little bit less when you use free Twist. So you have access to 1 month of comments and messages. So that means that you're only going to be able to look back at it for a little bit of time. And sure, you can have a lot of members and there is some integrations. But when it comes to Slack, when you look at Slack free, you have unlimited private and public channels, 10,000 searchable messages. So unless your company's sending you 10,000 a month, that's better than Twist. Up to 10 apps can connect to it. You actually get video calls, which is really nice, as well as voice calls. You can do file sharing and there are personalized notifications. So as you can see, the basics of Slack are a little bit better than Twist. But when it comes to the pricing for everything else, Twist Unlimited, which is the max top end plan that you can get, is actually only $5 a month. Whereas Slack has Pro for $667 and then Business for $1,250. Now, obviously for businesses, maybe they're gonna wanna go for Business Plus or Enterprise Grid because it's just what they need to be really secure with their messages. But we're talking about more day-to-day people or startups that have small people. Like if I start hiring people out, like what do I end up using to interact with those people? It might be something that makes more sense for Pro. For my unlimited version of Twist, because you actually get full access to comments and images. You have unlimited integrations and members. There's also file storage and you get obviously priority support since it's their highest tier. Now, when you look at Slack, the fact that you can actually do things like call people one-on-one is kind of next level and is something that Twist is definitely lacking on. Like I use Google Meet for what I do on Rise Productive with those that I interact with. And the fact that I have the ability to call like Chance through Slack with their plan is obviously better than Twist, because Twist, yes, I can interact with people and I can have something like Todoist integrated. And if you're looking to integrate something like Todoist with your chat app, maybe this is a good option. However, for those of you that don't know, in April of last year, Slack bought Woven Calendar. I don't know if you guys are familiar with Woven Calendar, but Woven Calendar was one of the best apps on the market that was like a Google Calendar alternative. So when you look at Slack, you have an application that is going to have workspaces and whatnot that actually allow you to interact with a calendar system. Whereas with Twist, you're really not getting as much in that regard. Sure, there are nice things like having a Google Calendar integration with Todoist that then goes into your interactivity with your business people in Twist. So there is an option there and it can be reasonable for $5 a month. But if we want to compare the integrations between the two, Slack is going to be winning in the integration section here. So if we look at it, we can see that they actually have just a ridiculous amount. They have Google Drive, Trello, Google Calendar, polls, calendars for Teams, Outlook, which you can't do on Twist. There's different Gmail ones, Confluence, all these different things. It even has a Todoist integration with Slack, which makes it seem like, you know, that's pretty hard to beat if it has more features than the company that comes from Todoist. And then they actually have a Notion thing where basically you can integrate it so that if a certain type of task was updated, it'll just like tell you that I edited something in Notion or that a status was changed, which is nice to interact with. If you're using your task management for your team in Notion, you could be like, hey, this is the channel to go to look at what project updates are going on. And then when it comes to Twist, you do have a lot of integrations with things like Asana, Calendly, Google Drive, Google Calendar, and obviously Todoist has the most amount of functionality with Twist as it is the same company. However, you can't use Outlook, but honestly, if you're going to use Outlook as a business, just use Microsoft Teams. I use it at work and it works really great. Honestly, my verdict is if you want to save a few bucks and have a very small team, I would go with Todoist and Twist as like a combination for what you're going to do organizationally. But if you have a larger team and you want to make it like a more all-in-one solution, I would use Slack. It's pretty great to have a company that's $12.5 a month and it's going to give you everything that you want. Even the $667 a month is pretty solid, and the pricing is going to be higher for Slack, but you're going to get more out of it if you want to make it your all-in-one thing. But I will say the last thing is, at scale, Twist is obviously going to be substantially cheaper. Say you have 10 people at a company, $5 per month per user, and you go 5 times 10, $50 a month. And then if you go to $667 a month, so let's actually do this for a year, it's $600. So then if you do the same thing, $667 a month times 10 people times 12, it's going to be $800 a year versus $600. So that's something you have to consider if you are a small business and want to be lean. Twist can do most of what it does. I personally think that if you're a small business, go with Twist. If you're a larger one and have more capabilities regarding your funds, probably go with Slack.
If you like this video and want to see more on other productivity apps, make sure to click this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.